Hello, I'm Ian Thane, and welcome to this weekly update on SAP Developer News.
As you may already know, SAP Graph is the new unified and consolidated API for SAP's integrated intelligent suite. You can use SAP Graph to build business applications that access a business data graph of SAP managed data, regardless of where that data is. This month sees the advent of new technical content, notably an SAP Graph introduction and the first two parts of a conversational tutorial series, where in the second part you'll end up building your first SAP Graph Hello World app. Check out the content on SAP Community.
Recently, our company has launched SAP Learning Hub edition for SAP NextGen, a free educational offering designed for students and lecturers. Starting from May, students at member institutions of the SAP University Alliances community have free access to learning content and resources to develop their SAP software skills and prepare for certifications. The new SAP Learning Hub edition for SAP NextGen includes free access to 18 different SAP learning journeys for key solutions, all related learning content and SAP learning rooms required to study for selected certifications, and a student-specific SAP learning room for community collaboration. If you are a student and are building your skills as a developer, then you can follow one or multiple learning paths available for you. Application development for SAP HANA, SAP UI5 and SAP Fiori applications, business intelligence and predictive analytics with SAP Analytics Cloud, SAP Integration Suite, or SAP Internet of Things. Just go to learninghub.sap.com/next-gen and register with your eligible university or school email address. Happy learning and good luck with your certification.
Hey everybody, Josh Bentley, Developer Advocate, and today I wanted to highlight for you a community member's blog post series. Cedric Heisel has published a two-part blog post series in which he takes you through the decisions that you can make to have a successful proof of concept on the business technology platform. In doing these blog posts, he breaks it into part one and part two. In part one, he focuses on some common questions, like which environment should I use and which services are going to be involved, and also what roles and team members do I need to have assigned to my proof of concept. In part two, Cedric moves on to how we're going to build our sample application, the front-end code is UI5, how do we leverage that with deployment to a CI/CD pipeline. So as you can see from my small recap, Cedric does a great job of laying out the foundation for your POC journey. Please read over these blog posts from our SAP community member, and if you have questions on your own BTP journey, reach out to Cedric and let him know how it's going and continue the dialogue.
I hope you were among almost 10,000 learners who enrolled and enjoyed the recent overview course called Exploring the World of Artificial Intelligence. We have great news for those of you who are interested in continuing the AI journey and interested in getting into more details. The openSAP course Getting Started with Data Science has started this week. This course is offered by Stuart Clark, a chief consultant with SAP Global Consulting Delivery. Stuart will introduce you to the fundamentals of data preparation, predictive modeling, data science, and the deployment and maintenance of models in business environments, all following a tried and tested project methodology based on his 25 years of experience in the field. You might remember that the original version of the course ran in 2017. Now, 4 years later, we are pleased to offer you the updated version. So go to open.sap.com/courses/ds3 and join others. More than 12,000 learners have enrolled by now already.